Hey, Pentax Tips here. Because converting your SDM to screwdrive autofocus is completely reversible, I decided to perform a speed test between the two focusing types. In a previous video, we demonstrated how to convert an older SDM autofocus lens to use its screwdrive focus system instead. Check a link in the description if you haven't seen that video yet. For this video, we are going to test the speed of both focus systems. Let's do some science. Here's some sample footage from the test, taken at 720p on my iPhone, apparently at 240 frames per second. I set up in my backyard and completed both min to max and maximum to minimum focusing tests for both the K70 and the K3 Mark III. And I did each test 30 times, because, you know, science. For the max distance, I used the side of my garage, which was conveniently just under 10 meters away, and the minimum being this focusing chart placed just over 1 meter away. I then converted my SDM to screwdrive and repeated the test. Here's the sample footage. Again, for both max to min and min to max.
18.
For both the 19. K70 and the K3 Mark III.
25. 26. 27. 28. 22. 3, 4.
Then in iMovie, I converted the video to 8x slow-mo. Here's what the sample slow-mo footage looks like. Now in Premiere Pro, I worked right to left, I don't know why, I just did. I would make clips of the slow-mo audio between the end of the first beep of focus confirmation and when the autofocus drive was first activated. I used both visual and audio cues for where to clip the start. Then I'd delete the audio for the focus repositioning and proceed to clip the next focus confirmation. Got to the point where I ran through and clipped everything first and deleted all the intervals afterwards. So once complete, I had the K70 audio here, the K3 audio here, and I have the max to min and min to max pairs for both the SDM and screwdrive focus systems. I then recorded all the times of each clip into Excel. So in Excel, I have the K70 times on the left, and I have the K3 Mark III times on the right. And under those, we have the SDM times on the left and the screwdrive on the right. Then we have the 2 max and the 2 min columns just underneath. Right off the bat, you can see the black cells. I don't know what I did wrong, but iMovie didn't convert the entire clip to slow-mo. So I still have some regular time and I didn't want to redo it. Also, there's a couple of cases where the sound of my counting overlapped too much with the focus confirmation beep, and it made it too hard to discern the timing, and so those were removed. So my lowest common denominator in my sample sizes is only 23. How will I sleep at night? Feel free to tell me my results are useless in the comments. So if you'll bear with me, here are our means. Again, these are all 8x slow-mo, our standard deviation, our standard error, and I reconverted these times back to normal time for reference. Great, I charted that. Looks like an improvement for sure. Now let's do some stats. My question is, does the speed decrease with treatment? So we can use a simple paired t-test. My null is no change in speed, meaning they're the same speed. And my alternative is speed A does not equal speed B, meaning there is a detectable difference. I'm going to open up the data analysis tool pack in Excel and select the t-test for paired two sample means. Select the K70's SDM 2 max column and then the K70 screwdrive 2 max column. Place my table in this sheet. Great, I'll do that again for the K70, but with the 2 min comparison. Again, in the same worksheet for easy comparison. Boom. Let's do the same thing for the K3. SDM 2 max and screwdrive 2 max. same worksheet. Done. And the K3 2-min SDM to screw drive. Same worksheet. Done. So to analyze this, there's a couple ways I see. First, look at our T-stat. R1 and 2 tailed T-critical will need to be lower than this T-stat to be able to reject our null hypothesis. So our T-stat is 6.0 and our 1 tailed critical is 1.7, which is less than our T-stat.
Same with the 2 tail.
So we can reject the null hypothesis for our K70 min to max autofocus speed test. We see the T-stat of the K70's max to min test is 7.5. Our 1-tail T-critical is 1.7, and our 2-tail is 2.0. Again, we can reject the null hypothesis. For the K3 Mark III 2 max, we see the T-critical is 4.3, and the T-critical 1-tail at 1.7, and the 2-tail at 2.0. Again, we can reject the null hypothesis. And lastly, for our K3 Mark III 2-min T-stat, we have 10.8, and our 1-tail is 1.7, and our 2-tail is 2.0. Again, we can reject the null. And to boot, all of our p-values are below our alpha of 0.05. So all around, we can reject the null hypothesis, and we can accept our alternative hypothesis. These are not the same speeds. Let's flip back over to our data. I'll end by calculating my speed improvement percentages between the max to min and min to max, and I am somewhat reasonably confident that converting your SDM to screwdrive will decrease the time of your autofocus speed by an average of 11.5%. And that's all the stats I have for you today. If you like this content and want to see more like it, please like and subscribe. Thanks.